If you're interested in volunteering abroad, there's a very wide range of projects you can get involved with. So just to give you a few ideas of how to make that decision and how to decide on what project you want to partake in. Four main considerations, and in terms of the priority on these, very different for different people. Areas to have a think about and decide from there what you want to do. First of these is the country or the location. There are particular countries that different people are interested in. It may be somewhere you've been before, it may be somewhere you've read about or seen in a documentary, and you're just interested in going there. It may be that you speak a language and you want to apply it. It may be that you want to learn a specific new language, and that country speaks it. It may be that you want to operate in your own language, so in English, and you want to go and work in an English-speaking country. It may be that you want to work in a hot country specifically or a cold country, so different people like different kind of climates. So all those considerations in location. Second consideration, quite a big area, which is the type of project. There's literally thousands of specific projects that you can work in, and you can round them down into about six fields, six categories, let's say. One project might actually cover all six categories, but you can kind of see from there what's available and try and round down your choices. First of these, environmental. Within environmental projects, three different areas even within that, so you may want to work, very hands-on, doing reforestation work, clearance, working sort of national park maintenance, that kind of stuff. Another area might be in developing new techniques, better ways of farming or environmental tourism or techniques in the home, such as the way that people use their stoves, that are more environmentally sound, so improving techniques. Or even environmental education, helping the locals of an area understand the importance of their environment and the ways that they operate and how that influences their environment to be able to conserve it for the future. Second area, so animals and wildlife. Whether you want to work in somewhere that is breeding back animals into the endangered animals, protecting their environment and their futures. There are breeding programs, lion breeding programs, right the way through to marine conservation, macaw conservation. And as an alternative to that, there's work with animals whereby you're working in rescue centres, animals that have been saved and need care. And thirdly, domestic animals. So, for example, working with horses in an equine therapy session where they're using the horses to help disabled children or something of that nature, again, all involved with animals and wildlife. The third type of project is community project. This is probably the biggest group, and it really is quite wide-ranging. They tend to be country-specific issues, so something that affects the Philippines is very different to what affects Bolivia or to what affects Ghana, but it could be building schools, building sanitation blocks, these kind of building group projects. It may be helping underprivileged groups, so anything from disabled children, the elderly, refugees, homeless, the abused, and there's various different projects that looks to help them in their situations. There's also providing opportunity for people in bad situations. For example, you can go to Thailand and help the women who are stuck in the sex industry and help them into to diff you know to get out of into different lifestyles, or also projects that are to do with the culture of an area where they're trying to conserve a drying tradition or build that culture or to educate people on the culture that continue. So community projects is a very big area. The fourth area is education. So whether you choose to work in a school, helping teachers, a teacher's assistant, especially where schools are under-resourced, they don't have the capacity to help the higher achieving children, the children that are falling behind, so providing assistance within that school environment. Outside of schools, in community groups, again, working with the children's education, in rural areas where there isn't as much expertise within the teachers, again, education is really vital. And also within special needs, so providing education for special needs groups, and also for adults, so not just for children, but education for adults to learn English, maybe to learn business skills, vocational education that can help them get jobs outside the area and or even within the area, but in fields they were previously uneducated in. Fifth area is health. So the health sectors in the developing countries often need a lot of help, and whether you're whether you've got no experience in health right the way through to being an experienced healthcare professional, there are placements where you can help, everything from helping the organisation within the clinics, whether it's dealing with the queues and the paperwork, right the way through to experienced professionals being able to practice out in the field, various different health arenas that you can assist in. And the last area is work with children. Very, very popular area, because there's an idea that if you build the youth of a country, that they can go on and make a better future for the area, and that they are the future of that destination, that location. Children's projects can be anything from working within orphanages, shelters, children's homes, with street children, everything from providing care for their upbringing right the way down from small babies up to older children who need a bit of attention, need some help in socialising with their homework, all of those elements, right the way through to projects that are helping children get out of bad situations, detracting them from, taking them away from the street gangs or from violence and from crime, and giving them opportunities in other areas, so working with children in that capacity. So there were the six areas of projects you can work in. So this brings us on to the third field for consideration, which is your length of stay. Now, projects are available from just 1 or 2 weeks right the way up to a year or more. And that will affect the kind of work that you can do. Certain work you need to get more involved, working with vulnerable children. There's a period where you need to develop a relationship and get their trust in order to be able to do better work. Needless to say, there are some very, very valuable work that can be done in just a short amount of time, because the volume of volunteers coming through allows that work to be constant and really builds on it. But consider, in the time that you've got available, what you're able to achieve, and choose a project that can really get the most out of it for the time that you've got available. And then the final area is your personal motivation. This is obviously very personal, and there's things that you shouldn't be ashamed of thinking about. Everyone wants to go to the destinations, and as a volunteer you want to contribute, you want to help, but there's always a secondary motive, and make sure that you speak this through with your project advisor, with the people who you'll be volunteering with, because it can be very important in choosing your project. So whether it's you're looking to work in a field that will help your career at home, are you a student who wants to do work in an area that'll help you get a job in that area? Do you have a specific skill that you're very keen to share and you want to bring to the project that you go to? Do you want to make sure that, you know, your placement is really working in an area that you want to develop in yourself, to learn a new language or develop a skill of your own? So really bring that out and it'll help you decide. All these areas should help you decide which project placement you'd be best to get involved in. But whatever choice you make, remember, you're not going to change the world on your own. What you're becoming part of is a wider group of people, a system, an infrastructure, whereby doing small incremental things builds to make a real difference. And you can be a part of that.